In 1986, Russell Mulcahy's Highlander claimed there can only be one. Connor MacLeod, played by Christopher Lambert, is an immortal swordsman who has been living unrecognized among humans for centuries and who repeatedly meets others like him with whom he fights to the death. Because in the end, for whatever reason, there can only be one. The ingenious British-American fantasy action film has an interesting story, a very good cast, a fantastic Queen Michael Kamen score, and an original, brilliant, fast-paced edit that cleverly distracts from the weaknesses of the script. Highlander, The Crown of Decapitation, was met with little understanding from its American distributors, which led to stupid cuts in the US version and a shitty marketing, as seen with the original US poster. It got mixed to positive reviews and didn't even make three-thirds of the $19 million budget back worldwide, and was at first a financial failure. This was primarily due to the poor performance in the back then still very important US market. In the rest of the world it was a success, became a hit on video and has quite rightly a cult status. Under same direction caused Highlander 2 The Quickening in 1991 confusion with audiences and laughter with critics. It plays in the distant future of 2024. So next year, Connor MacLeod is now an old man and the Earth is surrounded by an artificial energy shield that blocks the sunlight. It has replaced the lost ozone layer for 25 years, although the layer seems to have recovered. But the operators keep the population in the proverbial dark, since they don't want to lose their income from the shield. So a very similar fraud like the current global warming CO2 climate change scam. The audience learns that the immortals are aliens from the planet Zeist. When more Zeistian appear, Connor regenerates thanks to script power back into Highlander 1. And even Sean Connery, through the power of a paycheck, also comes back to life for a short, completely nonsensical guest appearance. Zeistlander 2 Financial Boogaloo is a complete disaster in which the story around is much more entertaining than the finished movie. It could barely make its over $30 million budget back worldwide and was for sure a flop. Shortly before the end of the shooting, it was clear they need more money. So some financiers took over, excluded the director and producer and gave the material to a third party to cut it together and shit it on the market. The completely confusing result with partially unfinished effects was rightly crucified by audiences and critics. In 1995, finally, a re-edited version appeared, created by the director, in which, among other things, the Zeistians simply come from the past and no longer from outer space. The so-called Renegade Cut. And in 2004 there was also a special edition, this time with improved or finished effects. All versions look cheap as hell, are boring as fuck, make no sense at all and have only trash entertainment value. But part 2 is still Citizen Kane compared to Highlander 3 The Sorcerer from 1994. The Canadian-French-English directorial debut ignores, like me, the predecessor and borrows the plot quite shameless from part 1, partially copying complete scenes and storylines. Connor MacLeod fights at first in the 16th century Japan and then present-day New York a Mongolian magician. Highlander 3 The Apology, as he was called by fans during the production time, comes off unimaginative, looks like shit and is dull like hell.
Shell
was barely able to pull back the similar high production costs as Part 2 and, of course, another flop. Music video specialist Andy Morehands tried his luck in 1997 and 2009 with two more features, both also unimaginative garbage. In 1992, Highlander aired on TV with 119 45-minute episodes in 6 seasons. The fantasy series, which is very popular with its fans, is roughly based on the original movie and about Duncan MacLeod, played by Adrian Paul, a relative to Connor MacLeod, who has a short appearance in the pilot. I personally watched a few episodes back then, not voluntarily of course, but with my girlfriend. Thanks God the relationship didn't last long, so I didn't have to finish this boring as fuck. This highly interesting new infusion of an already done to death idea. While the series was still running, another version of the story aired in 1994 with Highlander the animated series, this time with 20-minute episodes. It takes place 700 years in the future after a global catastrophe, in which people seem to be forced by an evil immortal to live like in the medieval times. Sounds they got also eco-fascists. Here comes Quentin MacLeod into play, who tries to free mankind. In 1996, there was also a compilation of some episodes thrown onto the market as Highlander The Adventure Begins. The series was cancelled after 40 episodes in 2 seasons and with me, as usual, after 2 minutes because I don't give a fuck. 1998, the real-life TV series ended and got a spin-off with Highlander The Raven, this time with a female Highlander whatsoever. Amanda is a 1200-year-old thief and ex-girlfriend of the Highlander, with already several appearances in the Highlander TV series. Like many potential viewers back then, I could successfully avoid the show. And after 22 episodes came the cancellation due to low ratings. In 2000, another directorial debut, Highlander Endgame, tried its luck as a continuation of the TV series, with the TV-lander in the lead and the cinema-lander as support. Duncan and Connor MacLeod face an opponent together who had, thanks to script power, already more quickenings than both of them combined, doesn't need to stick to any rules, and of course, as always, only remains invincible until he simply isn't anymore. Flashback Lander 4, end of line for Connor, made just over half of its $25 million budget back worldwide. And was, as usual, a flop, no surprise here, I guess. Since the uninteresting story does neither follow any roots from the small nor the big screen predecessors, TV specialist Doug Arnokovsky was probably the right choice when it came to showing zero feeling for the subject matter, pissing off as many old and new fans as possible, giving a franchise that's already deadly wounded another step in the back, and avoiding making profit under any circumstances. If that sounds like the Steph Search advert for fake track disgustery, I'm sure that's no coincidence, since he was also responsible for several god-awful episodes in the STD abomination.
Damn!
Level up! Level up! Level up!
Okay.
Level up! Level up! Level up!
Okay.
2007, Highlander The Source went straight to TV after the cinema release date was changed a few times. I'm pretty sure the responsible people realized that this dirt can't be saved. It is another continuation of the TV series and takes place a few years in the future, where society is supposedly heading for the end. This can, for reasons, perhaps be prevented if a certain source is found, guarded by invincible opponent of the week number 5874, The Guardian. And as usual, rules, strengths or weaknesses are made up as they went along. For once, the director was not an untalented newcomer as in Part 3 and 4, but with Brett Leonard, an experienced crap and flop generator, delivering with this piece of shit one of the worst movies ever made. Borlander 5, The Source of Boredom, is without doubt the weakest entry of the series with zero entertainment value whatsoever, and was quite rightly beheaded by audiences and critics.
Level up!
At least by the few who could sit through this shit. In the same year came also the American-Japanese Highlander The Search for Vengeance.
Level up! Level up!
This version of the story takes place 200 years in the future and is about two immortals who are trying to kill each other since 2000 years.
Okay, I keep on running until I level up. I get that speed and I level up.
Level up! Level up! Level up!
bars make your head spin like a barrel roll. I'm Sonic racing, just see me go. I EMC so easily, like Yoshi does with his enemies. Oh shit, is going out the window. Switched it up just like Nintendo. Minecraft a game just to go diamond. Whipped it up just like I'm Simon. Blow as hard as a radium, I smash you down to oblivion. I'm like an R-Wing, I fly high. I got the killer instinct of a Street Fighter. Finally, time to smash King K. Boo. I got that 8-bit swag, man, I'm so old school.
Level up, level up, level up.
Okay.
Level up, level up, level up.
Okay, I keep on grinding until I level up. I get that XP then I level up.
Level up, level up, level up.
Okay.
Level up, level up, level up.
Okay.
Level up, level up, level up.
Okay, I keep on grinding until I level up. I get that XP then I level up.
Level up, level up.
While the rogue is mainly interested in power, the hero has only his revenge in mind. The beautiful anime has an interesting story, is entertainingly staged, and was rightly well received by fans and critics. It's much better than all of the sequels or TV shows.